Good evening, students. So there was a live stream actually. So due to a certain technical problem, we could not do that. So it is a pre-recorded session for class 9 polynomials, chapter number 2 polynomials. So the chapter number 2 is polynomials. So by the word polynomials, what do you understand? So in earlier classes we studied about algebra. So polynomial is also an algebra. So in earlier classes, in class 8, we studied about algebra. That is variable plus constant. Okay, so polynomial is also an algebra, but it has a condition that the power of the variable must be a whole number. So what can you write? A polynomial is also an algebraic expression, also an algebraic expression with just a condition. What is the condition? What will be the condition? That this variable, the power of this variable, the power of this variable must be a whole number. Condition that the power of the variable, say x. So we denote variable as x. So we say x with that the variable is x is a whole number. Okay, this is the condition that the power of the variable is a whole number. So note this down. So after that, in other words, we can say polynomial is also variable plus constant. Okay, noted this much. So take a screenshot and note it down. So in other words, we can say polynomial is equal to variable plus constant. So the variable may be 2x plus 3, 4x plus 7, 4y plus 6, 6x square plus 7, 6x cube plus 6. These all are polynomials. Okay, so now we also studied about coefficient in class 8. So let us take the example of 2x plus 3. In 2x plus 3, which is the variable and which is the constant? Variable is equal to 2x and constant is equal to 3. So here the variable is x. 2x is the variable, we say, but 2 is the coefficient of x. Okay, understood this much? For example, if we take another example, like say minus 7x plus 5. So variable would be minus 7x, constant would be 5, and minus 7 would be the coefficient of x. Understood this much? Now in suppose assume a polynomial. In polynomial, say I take x square plus 2x. Okay, here x square and 2x are called terms. What are they called? They are called as terms. Okay, next is zero polynomial. Suppose we have a polynomial only 2. Is also a polynomial, Now how will you say 2 is a polynomial? It is a constant term. So how we can say that 2 is a polynomial? Like 0, we can write 0x plus 2, which is a polynomial, which becomes a variable and constant. So this is also polynomial. So such polynomials are known as zero polynomial. Understood this much? So let us move to next. Here we have three formulas, algebraic identities. We will discuss about three algebraic identities. That is, number one, the ink is low. Let me refill the ink. So, we have three identities. Number one, x plus y whole square. So, x plus y whole square is x square plus 2xy plus y square. So, how can we write? If we are asked to prove this, so what will we do? X plus y whole square, we take LHS equal to x plus y whole square equal to x plus y into x plus y. Okay, now using distributive property of plus y into x plus y. Again, using distributive property, x into x plus x into y. Remember, this is x. This is multiplication symbol. This is variable. This is symbol plus y into x plus y into y. So it becomes x square plus xy plus a into b or b into a. Both are equal or not? Let us see, 2 into 3 or 3 into 2. Both will give answer 6. So they are equal. So, xy plus y square. So, how many x square, xy are there? 1xy, 2xy plus y square. So, we had already proved this. LHS equal to RHS. Okay? So, similarly, we can also prove for another terms. Take a screenshot of that. Rewind and take a screenshot. So, second identity would be x minus y whole square equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. Third is x square minus y square equal to x minus y, x plus y. Okay? Understood this much? Then we can move to next. Now let us understand the degree of the polynomial. What is degree of the polynomial? Suppose we have the polynomial, say, from the book. Take a screenshot of this formula and note it down. Now let us understand the degree of the polynomial. What is the degree? So suppose we have number 1, x5 minus x4 plus 3. Here what is the highest power? Here we have two variables x. So what is the highest power? The highest power of the variable, highest power of the variable is 5. So the degree of this polynomial, this complete is known as polynomial. This polynomial is 5. Okay, understood? Now let us take another example. Example number 2. So I will write shortly now. Number 2. 2 minus y square minus y cube plus 2y8. Here all the variables are y. So highest power is equal to 8. So degree is equal to what? 8. Number 3. 2. Here what I said? In last example, I told you about zero polynomial. This can be written as 0x plus 2. Or it can be written as 2x to the power 0, which gives you 2. Okay? So the degree will be either 0. Sorry, this one is not allowed actually. So it can be written as 2x to the power 0. So the degree will be 0. Understood this much? So come to exercise 2.1. Which of the following expression are polynomials in one variable and which are not? State reason for your answer. This one is direct answer. One and two. Number one, 4x square minus 3x plus 7 and y square, number 2, y square plus root 2 are polynomials in one variables. Are polynomials in one variables. But polynomial 5, this number 5, big number 5, x to the power 10 plus y to the power 3 plus t to the power 50 are polynomial in how many variables? 1, 2 and 3. 3 variables. and rest remaining number 3, 3 root t plus t root 2 and 4 y plus 2 y are not polynomials. So can you say why they are not termed as polynomials? Because we in a polynomial there must be the power must be in the power must be in whole number, and here they are not in whole numbers. The power the variable the power of variable are not whole numbers. So this is your first answer. Next, number 2. Number 2, write the coefficients of x square. Number 2, write the coefficients of x square in each of the following. In each of the following. So first question, number 1, 2 plus x square plus x. Here what is the coefficient of x square? X square divided by x square is equal to 1. So the coefficient is, therefore the coefficient is of x square is 1. Second number, 2 minus x square, 2 minus x square plus x cube. Here x square minus x square divided by x square gives you minus 1. Therefore the coefficient of x square is minus 1. Okay. Next, number 3. Number 3, pi by 2 x square plus x. So pi by 2 x square divided by x square. X square cancel. So pi by 2. Therefore, the coefficient of x square is pi by 2. Next, do it by yourself. There is no x square, so there will be no coefficient. Next, give one example of a binomial of degree 35 and monomial of degree 100. This one you can directly do. That is number 3, 3x 35 minus 2 and root 2 y 100. This is binomial, or you can write this binomial of 35 is equal to 3x 35 minus 2 and monomial of power 100 is equal to root 2 y 100. And you can also write different coefficients also. नेक्स्ट नंबर फोर, नेक्स्ट नंबर फोर, राइट द डिग्रीज ऑफ ईच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पॉलिनोमियल्स. नंबर फोर, नंबर वन, फर्स्ट आई विल राइट द क्वेश्चन, आफ्टरवर्ड्स आई विल गिव यू आंसर. 5x³ + 4x² + 7x. हियर द हाईएस्ट पावर इज x³, सो डिग्री इक्वल टू 3. सेकेंड वन, 4 - y² the highest here in y variable the highest power is 2, so degree will be 2. Number 3 will be 5t - √7, so degree of t is 1. Number 4, you do by yourself. Next, number 5. Classify the following as linear, quadratic and cubic polynomials. So, what are linear polynomial, what is cubic polynomial, what is quadratic polynomial? First of all, know the definition. Last year I taught you. Linear polynomial. A polynomial with degree 1 is known as linear polynomial. Quadratic polynomial for example 3x + 2 or 3x or 9 - 9x + 7, these are linear polynomial examples. Polynomial with degree 2, example 3x² + 2 or 3x² or -9x² + 7x + 2. Cubic polynomial with degree 3. Example 3x³ + 5x² + 2x. So you do number 5 as homework and WhatsApp me and I will check your answers. Okay, so for now you see this video and try to solve exercise 2.1. On the next video we will be shooting for exercise 2.2. Thank you.